Hello students, how are you? Our today's topic is about some properties regarding integers. I will tell you about the distributive property and few problems based on addition and subtractions. Okay, basically it's a very easy topic, but sometimes the questions have different patterns in which basic addition and subtractions are involved, and we have to decide what should we do. Okay, now let's start. On the screen you can see I have written few rules regarding multiplication of integers. As you know, the integers have both positive and negative signs. For example, 5 is an integer and minus 5 is also an integer, and on the number line we can easily represent it. So regarding multiplication, here I have given two rules. First one is, if minus sign appears in odd numbers, then the answer is negative. Okay, let me elaborate the meaning of this. Suppose we are multiplying four numbers. As in the question, 3 multiplied by minus 4 multiplied by minus 2 multiplied by minus 1. Here minus sign appears 3 times, okay? So 3 is an odd number. Here this odd means how many times minus sign appears. So there is minus 2, minus 4 and minus 1. 3 times the minus sign is there. In this case, our answer will be negative. Okay, so if we multiply ordinarily without considering the sign, how we will do? See carefully, 3 4 ja 12, 12 2 ja 24, and 24 1 ja 24. The value will be 24. Okay, and what about the sign? As I told you, 3 times minus sign appears here, so in our answer there will be minus sign, so answer will be minus 24. Okay, and in the second, it is given that if minus sign appears in even numbers, okay, for example there is minus 1 and is minus 1, minus 3, minus 2 and minus 10 all have negative signs. So what should we do here? Okay, so we will multiply these first, okay, without considering the sign. As 3 1 ja 3, 3 2 ja 6 and 6 10 ja 60, the value 60. But you might be thinking that what happened with all the negative signs? As there are 4 negative signs and 4 is an even number, so our answer will be positive, there will be no negative sign. So you must remember both the rules. How many times the minus sign is there in the product of many numbers? Now come to the next point, distributive property. There is a verification given regarding distributive property. On the left hand side it is given 9 multiplied by 2 values 2 and minus 4 and adding them equal to this one. So what we are doing, students, even we can solve it in a direct way without using property, but we have to do in a proper way. So we will do 9 is multiplied by 2 and with minus 4. So here 9 multiplied by 2 and multiplied by minus 4. On the left hand side if we are solving it directly, because we have to verify it, so we need to solve both the sides. This 2 plus minus 4 becomes minus 2, and multiply by 9, it gives minus 18. And on the right hand side, this 9 2 ja 18, and this 9 4 ja becomes minus 36. Finally, we have 18 plus minus 36. It is 18 minus 36, and with the help of basic addition subtraction rules, we can find it is minus 18. Both the answers are correct. Okay, on the left hand side and right hand side, both are correct. So I am trying to elaborate the concept of distributive property. Why we say it the distributive property means something may be distributed here. Okay, so what is distributed over here? See, this is a multiply sign, and here is also multiply sign. If you see very carefully, you can feel on the left hand side there is only one multiply sign, that is here, and on RHS there are two multiply signs, here and here. So we can say multiplication is distributed over addition. Okay, I repeat again, multiplication is distributed over addition. That's why it is called distributive property. Sometimes it can be distributed over subtraction also. The only difference is we have minus sign instead of plus sign. I hope you are getting. See, now finding the answer using appropriate property. Okay, sometimes we have to use the distributive or associative or some other properties, but if it is asked to use a property, never solve a question in a direct way. Always use the property. Here 5 multiplied by minus 8 and minus 8 multiplied by minus 10, and finally we are adding the values. So my distributive property, it is already distributed actually, because we can see both these multiplications are distributed over addition. Now the minus 8 appears in both the expressions. Okay, you can see minus 8 is there, this one and this one. So we will take minus 8 common. Common means a term or a value which appears in two or more expressions, that is called common. So minus 8 is taken common here, and what term will remain in the first expression? If we take minus 8 out, we will have 5. So we are writing 5 here, 5, and from there if we are taking minus 8 common, we have minus 10, that is here. Obviously in the bracket we have minus 5, and outside is minus 8. Again there are negative signs 2 times, so the answer will be positive, and 8 5 is 40. So for the whole expressions, whatever the multiplication and addition subtractions we are doing, out of them we have 40 as the answer. If you have the problem in any topic, then you can ask your doubts from your school log app, and you can also see this video 2 or 3 times. Next problem is based on basic addition and subtraction, but it is not given in the question. Okay, the question is about in an exam 5 marks are given for any correct answer. It means if a student has appeared in an exam, if he has write correct answers, then 5 marks will be given for each correct answer, and minus 2 marks are given for each incorrect answer, because if he will do something wrong, then minus marks will be given to him, and 0 for not attempted. Means if he has not attempted any question, he will get 0. The condition is that if a student gets 4 correct and 6 incorrect answers, what is his score? Finally, we want to find the score of the students if he has done 4 correct answers and 6 incorrect answers. Now in the next slide, the whole process is given for this. The score is, and according to question we have to find out the positive score and negative score, as he is attempting some correct answers and some incorrect answers. So for the correct answers he will get positive marks, and for incorrect answers he will get negative marks. Now look back in the previous slide, 5 marks are given for every correct answer and -2 marks are given for every incorrect answer. So 5 and -2 will play a very important role here. Again, this 5 multiplied by 4, because it is given that 4 correct and 6 incorrect answers he has attempted. So for 4 correct answers he will obtain 20 marks, and for every incorrect answer he is getting 6 marks minus 2 marks. Okay, so for all the incorrect answers which are 6, he will observe minus 12 marks, as we are multiplying 6 by minus 2, and the total marks are the sum of both these, as 20 and minus 12. So 20 is for correct answers and minus 12 for incorrect answers. If we add them, 20 plus minus 12 will become 20 minus 12, and it is 8. Ultimately we can say he will get 8 marks overall. Okay, so these marks depend on the questions attempted by him or questions left by him, and it is very important to consider how many correct answers and how many incorrect answers are given by him. So students, I hope you are getting this topic properly. Okay, let's revise these topics once again in a short way. Okay, here product of integers, if minus sign appears odd number of times. Okay, for example, I write an example here. For example, minus 1 multiplied by minus 2 multiplied by minus 3 and multiplied by minus 4. Okay, one more multiplied by minus 5. Now see, all these numbers are multiplied together and negative also. First we have to do multiplication without considering the sign. Now forget the sign, then I will tell you how to take the sign. So 1 2 ja 2, 2 3 ja 3, 1 2 ja 2, 2 3 ja 6. Okay, 2 3 ja 6, then 6 4 ja 24. All right, 24 5 ja 225. Okay, it is 120 overall, it is 120. 1 2 ja 2, 2 3 ja 6, 6 4 ja 24, and 24 5 ja 120. All right, it is 120. Now don't be confused, minus sign is appearing 5 times. As I told you, it is an odd number, so we will put minus sign with our answer, hence it is minus 20. Now according to the property, how we will do? See, if we multiply both these we get a positive value. Multiplying by minus 3 and 4 together it will give plus 12, and the minus 5 will remain alone because there is no negative number, and if we multiply all this we will get minus 120. All right, here again distributive property, as you have learnt in earlier classes that how to use distributive property for integers, for whole numbers and for rational numbers. So the multiplication is distributed over addition. Remember always, this statement is very important because you are supposed to know the meaning of distributive. If I distribute something, okay, then it is called a distributive. So here this multiply sign is distributed over here 2 times, that's why it is called distributive property. And then it will be followed by basic arithmetic operations, we will get the answers. Okay, here this is also another use of distributive property, by taking some values as a common, and inside the bracket, inside this bracket, we will write the remaining terms. For example, minus 8 is taken common, the 5 will remain, and here minus 8 is taken common, minus 10 is remaining. So in the bracket we are writing 5 and minus 10. By using basic arithmetic operations we will find the answer. As you know, the basic properties of addition and subtractions. I hope so that you know it very well, what to do with some positive and negative quantities when they are added or subtracted with each other. I think it should not be complicated for you, and this example is also important. If someone attempts correct answers, he will get a positive number. If someone attempts negative answers, he will get a negative number, obviously. And to know the final score or the marks obtained by him, we will add both the values and get the answers. All right. So here we are completed. I hope you got it properly, all the informations which are given in the slides. Okay. Somewhere if you have a problem, you can also pause the videos and see everything carefully. Try to solve the questions which are given in your assignment, and it will be clear. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Have a good day.